Hello everyone, this is Dr. Manoj Kumbhalkar. Today we learn about the topic universal or hook joint of subject theory of machine 1. So in this lecture we discuss about the theoretical concept of the hook joint as well as the numerical background of the hook joint. So at the end of this lecture the students can draw the polar diagram for the fluctuation of speed between the driving shaft and the driven shaft. So mainly the fluctuation occurs at the driven shaft speed. So for that we have to draw a polar diagram. Okay. So what is the hook joint? A hook joint, commonly known as universal coupling, is used to connect two non-parallel and intersecting shaft. Actually, it's a hook joint is nothing but the universal coupling. Universal coupling is a part of that flexible coupling. So there are two types of coupling, rigid and flexible. So in the flexible coupling there is some misalignment between the driving and driven shaft. So universal coupling is a part of flexible coupling and there is also a misalignment between the driving and driven shaft. So in the universal coupling or in the hook joint, it is used when angular misalignment between the shaft is up to 40 degrees. So in this hook joint there is an angular misalignment is there. Please see the picture. This is the driving shaft having that the axis is the axis of driving shaft and there is some angle with the axis of the driven shaft. Okay, so in the hook joint there is angular misalignment is that, and the limitations is there is up to the 40 degrees. This joint is also used for transmission of power to different spindles in a multiple drilling machine, knee joint in a milling machine, in rolling mills, etc. And mainly it is used in many industries application and in a huge size of the joint. Okay, so for basically for the power transmission. The main disadvantage of single hook joint is velocity ratio is not constant. So there basically there are two types of hook joint, single hook joint and double hook joint. So now we are discussing about the single hook joint. So as it is, this is the flexible coupling, there is some misalignment, so therefore the velocity ratio will not be constant. Therefore the main disadvantage of that hook joint is the velocity ratio is not uniform or it is not constant. A single hook joint consists of two U-shaped forks, each connected to driving and driven shaft. So this is the driving shaft, this is U-shaped fork, sorry, this is the U-shaped fork of the driving shaft and this is the U-shaped fork of the driven shaft, and it is connected at its at four ends with the help of this cross. Okay, so that the four ends are connected by a center piece called as a cross. So this is the disassembled part of the hook joint. You can check here, this is the driving shaft, that here is mentioned as tubular shaft. This is the sliding yoke, it is nothing but the driving shaft, driven shaft, and this is the cross. So this cross is connected at this point and here is at this point. Okay, and remaining are the parts of that hook joint. So after assembly these parts are required. Here is one of that universal coupling, it is just like a ball and socket joint, and this is the universal joint, okay, or hook joint. These are some applications of hook joint. Here it is, first is the, you can check that hook joint is used to the shaft which is came from the gear drive. Here is the coupled of the one of the machine. Coupling of one of the machine. Here is that huge hook joint. It is used for that. This is the coupling, rigid coupling, and from the shaft is shaft from that rigid coupling. It joined with the help of that hook joint. Okay, so here is also one of the industry application used in the large scale industry. Now we discuss about the hook joint analysis, how that velocity ratio has been calculated, and based on that we have to find out the polar diagram of that driving and driven shaft. So mainly the expectation is what you have, we have to find out the angular velocity of the driven shaft, or we can say the speed of the driven shaft. So you can check here the top view and front view of the section. So this AB line is the AB and the horizontal and vertical line is the fork of driving shaft, and this CD and this perpendicular line is the fork of the driven shaft. Okay, so the angle between the driving and driven shaft is alpha. So just clear the concept of that angles. The angle between the two shafts is nothing but the alpha, simply alpha. Okay, so thereafter you can check the front view. This is the circle AB. Okay, so that circle AB is nothing but the driving shaft speed. So if we if the driving shaft starts rotating, so this if it is driving shaft, it starts rotating. So first of all, it is at this position. It starts rotating. It takes the position like this. It means it forms an angle with the this one. Okay, so that angle is nothing but the theta. So if the driving shaft will rotate simultaneously, the driven shaft will start the rotating. But as this is the flexible coupling, there is some misalignment between the coupling. So therefore, the angle made by the driving shaft during its rotation will not be equal to the angle made by the driven shaft. It may also be same, but due to the misalignment, there is some fluctuation in the angles also. So that angle made with the driven shaft is nothing but the phi. Okay, so for the driving shaft, the AB is situated to A1 B1, and for the driven shaft, CD is situated to C1 D1. So from this analysis, we get the formula for the velocity ratio. So the angular velocity of driven shaft to the angular velocity of driving shaft will be equals to cos alpha divided by 1 minus cos square theta sin square alpha. So that is also equals to that n2 by n1, because it's a speed and it's angular velocity. This is the same. Okay. Based on that angular velocity, we can find out the maximum and minimum speed of the driven shaft, because there is the speed fluctuation in the driven shaft. So therefore, the maximum and minimum velocity we will get from that angular velocity ratio. So omega 1 is the angular velocity of driving shaft, and omega 2 is the angular velocity of the driven shaft. So we can use that angular velocity formula. So based on that, the omega 2, we will get the omega 2 is equals to omega 1 into the complete relation. So the value of, it is required omega 2. So the value of omega 2 will be maximum for a given value of alpha. So that for the given value of alpha, it will be maximum if the denominator is minimum. If this denominator is minimum, that value of the omega 2 will be maximum. Okay. So how the denominator will be minimized? So if the cos square theta is equals to 1, so cos square theta is equals to 1, it means what? That theta will be equals to 0 degree and 180 degree. Okay. So if the driven shaft angle is 0 degree or it is completely 180 degree, in that case, the speed of the driven shaft is maximum. Okay. So if you put the value of that cos square theta in that relation, you will get the omega 2 max will be equals to omega 1 divided by cos alpha, or n2 max is equals to n1 by cos alpha. Likewise, the minimum speed of the driven shaft, again using the same relation. So how will we get the minimum speed of the driven shaft? Similarly, the value of omega 2 is minimum if the denominator of equation is maximum. So this will happen if that denominator term is maximum. So in that case, cos square theta should be equal to 0, and if the cos square theta is 0, in that case the theta will be equal to 90 degree and 270 degree. Okay, so therefore that omega 2 relation will get omega 1 into cos alpha. So check the difference, that if the theta is 0 degree and 180 degree, the speed of the driven shaft is maximum, and if the theta is 90 degree and 270 degree, so speed of the driven shaft is minimum. Okay, again we if the there is some fluctuation of speed, but there will be some conditions where the speed of the driving shaft will be equals to the speed of the driven shaft. So we can check this equal speed in the polar diagram. So it means what, if the omega 1 is equals to omega 2, then in that case the relation is will get tan theta is equals to plus minus under root of cos alpha, okay, and the angular acceleration will get it from this relation. The maximum fluctuation of speed is nothing but the difference between that speed of the driven shaft and the minimum speed of the driven shaft. So it will obtained as omega 1 alpha square. Then we will see the double hook joint. So what is the difference between that single and double hook joint, and what is the advantage of double hook joint over the single hook joint? So in the double hook joint, one intermediate shaft is used. That intermediate shaft will contain the two forks in the one side and in the second side, okay. And if this is the driving shaft, there will be one fork, and if there is a driven shaft, there will be here is the another fork, and this is the intermediate shaft having again two forks, okay. So the angle made between the driving shaft and the angle made between the driven shaft will be same. So therefore in the double hook joint there is very less fluctuation of speed, or we can say the negligible fluctuation of speed. So therefore the mainly double hook joint may be referred, but single hook joint can be used because it will not occupy a maximum space. The axis of the driven and driven shaft are in same plane, and the driving and driven shaft makes equal angle with the intermediate shaft. So this is the main advantage of the double hook joint. Here are some there is some video of the double hook joint. This is the intermediate shaft, this is a driving shaft, and this is a driven shaft, okay. There are some pictures of another double hook joint. Here are some difference between single and double hook joint. It is helpful for the students for exam point of view. In single hook joint, the speed of driven shaft is not uniform. That point is we already discussed. And in the double hook joint, the speed is uniform. We can say the speed is constant. Therefore, the velocity ratio obtained in single hook joint is not uniform. It is relevant to that first point. And therefore, the velocity ratio obtained in the double hook joint is uniform, obviously. At the high speed, single hook joint causes vibration. There may be some chances of the vibration in the single hook joint, but in the double hook joint it is not present, okay. So there is no intermediate shaft between the driving and driven shaft in the single hook joint, and the intermediate shaft is used in the double hook joint. So these are the theoretical concept of completely the hook joint. Hereafter we have to solve some numerical over the hook joint to draw a polar diagram. So we consider one numerical. Angle between two shafts connected by a hook joint is 25 degree. So this is the angle between two shafts. It means what? This is alpha. So alpha is given, that is 25 degree. If the driving shaft is rotating at 1000 rpm, find out. So the speed of driving shaft is given, that is n1 is equals to 1000 rpm. So we have to find out the minimum speed of driving shaft and the maximum speed of driving shaft. Also, the driving shaft rotation angle at which driven and driving shaft speed are same. So here the question is that also draw schematic polar diagram for above hook joint indicating all important values. Okay. So first of all, we have to find out the speed of driven shaft analytically, and hereafter that value has to be put in the polar diagram, okay. So we know the relay equations for that maximum speed of driven shaft and minimum speed of deviation we already discussed in the previous slide. So therefore the maximum speed of driven shaft is n2 max is equals to n1 divided by cos alpha. We know the value of n1, it is given. We know the value of alpha, it is also given. You will get that 1103 0.37 rpm. This is the maximum speed of driven shaft, and check that if the this is that speed is greater than the speed of the driving shaft. Okay. Then the minimum speed of the driven shaft is n1 cos alpha. Again putting the values, you will get the 906.30 rpm. Okay. So that values, this is the minimum and this maximum. So you know that the minimum maximum speed is occurs at 0 degree and at 180 degree, and the minimum speed is occurred at 90 degree and 270 degree. Okay. Then for the equal speed of the driving and driven shaft, so you can check here that there is intersection of that point 1, 2, 3, and 4. So at this point, the speed of the driving shaft and speed of the driven shaft are equal. Okay, it is nothing but that 1000. So at this point, the speed will be 1000. But what is that angle where that speed is equal? So we have to find out that tan theta is equal to plus minus under root of cos alpha. So plus minus under root of cos 25 will get plus minus 0.952. So if we find out that angles, that tan inverse of plus 0.952, so theta will get as 43.59 and 223.59. So that angle made is nothing but 43.59, and the second one is this is nothing but the 223.59. At that point, the speed is equal. And also, if we get the tan inverse of minus 0.952, you will get that angle 136.5 and 316.5. Okay. So these are the angles calculated with the help of the that relation. Now we will find out that we will draw the polar diagram. So check, this is the polar diagram of that drawing. So how that polar diagram is made, we check that one. First of all, you have to draw a circle. So that circle, just a minute. So first of all, draw a circle. I overlap the my circle over that diagram, so you can understand how that diagram has been prepared. So this is the first of all, draw the circle. Circle is center. Circle indicates the speed of the driving shaft, because there is no any fluctuation of speed in the driving shaft. There is only fluctuation of speed in the driven shaft. So therefore, the speed of driving shaft is uniform. That is 1000 rpm. Okay. So 1000 rpm means you have to take a scale. You can take a scale of we can put it as here 1 centimeter. Is equals to 100 rpm. Okay, so it means you have to draw a circle of 10 centimeter. First of all, draw the circle of 10 centimeter. Okay, so thereafter, there is a fluctuation of speed in the driven shaft. Therefore, for the driven shaft, there will not be a circle. There will be an ellipse, because the speed is fluctuated from maximum to minimum. Okay. So n2 max will occur at 0 degree and 180 degree. Okay, and n2 minimum will occur at 90 degree and 270 degree. Okay, so therefore just plot that point 1103 divided by 100. So it is 11 centimeter, 11.03. just to place a point over that one. That point is 1103 at 0 degree. This is the 0 degree, and thereafter at then 180 degree, you have to plot again 11.03 from the center. There is plus, there is minus. Okay. Then the minimum speed, that is 906.30, again divide by 100, it is 9.06. So this angle, this point is occurs at 90 degree and 270 degree. So here is 90 degree, plot a point 90, and here is at 270 degree, plot a point 906. So this is the maximum and minimum speed. But how that ellipse will form? So therefore, for that we will require that angles where the speed of the driving and driven shaft is equal. So first of all, plot angle 43.59. So from this point, take an angle of 43.59. So this angle is 43.59. Okay. Thereafter, you have to plot an angle of 136.549. Again. Sorry. Angle of first of all it is 43.59, okay, then 136.59, then it is 223, sorry, this was the 223, here 136, so draw all the angles, then here is. Okay, so draw angle, all the angles with the help of your angle measurement device. Okay, then hereafter you can point out that points you can point out that points here is the cross. With that red color circle. So with the help of that, you just join all the points, you will get an ellipse. Okay. You will get an ellipse. That's it. Okay, so this is the polar diagram. Here it is indicated as the circle is the speed of the driving shaft, ellipse is the speed of the driven shaft, where is fluctuation is, this is the maximum speed, minimum speed, and at this point the speed of this driving, that is 100,000 rpm, and speed of the driven is also the 100,000 rpm. Okay, so this is the polar diagram. This is the numerical concept of the Hooke's joint. So you can draw the polar diagram for the remaining questions. You can now draw the polar diagram for the Hooke's joint. Thank you. Thank you very much.